Kyiv's mayor with an urgent warning today that Russia still plans to seize all of Ukraine. And the Ukrainian capital is actually Moscow's main target, he says. Ukraine says Russian forces are targeting dozens of towns in the eastern part of the country. There have been fierce battles around Severodonetsk as Russia tries to encircle outnumbered and outgunned Ukrainian defences. Well, in already battered Kharkiv, yet more shelling today, killing at least four people and wounded seven. And Ukraine's foreign minister warns that Russia is trying to blackmail the world with its offer to unblock Ukrainian seaports and grain supplies if sanctions against Moscow are eased. Or part of his country in flames, Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky has made a blistering attack on Henry Kissinger. Now, it comes after the former US Secretary of State appeared to suggest that Ukraine should give up territory to Russia in peace negotiations. Mr. Zelensky compared Kissinger's views to the appeasement of the Third Reich back in 1938, saying, and I quote, "In the real year, 1938, when Mr. Kissinger's family was fleeing Nazi Germany, he was 15 years old. Well, CNN international diplomatic editor Nick Robertson joining us live from Geneva. And this was a blistering attack by the Ukrainian president. Today, the German chancellor wrapping up the World Economic Forum in Davos, suggesting simply we cannot allow Putin to win his war. What do we make of these Kissinger comments?
Well, they're very troubling for the Ukrainians, and actually for positions that it appears many European governments in the United States have taken. I mean, we know from the United States their view is that Putin should come out of this weaker, that he shouldn't be enabled. Olaf Scholz today speaking at Davos said Putin shouldn't be able to dictate the terms of the peace. We've heard from the British Foreign Secretary as well, saying very much the same sort of thing today. And this is the narrative that we've heard from European Union and other leaders. So what President Zelensky is saying is, he's drawing this analogy between Henry Kissinger saying that that there should be peace negotiations that would essentially push Russia back to the pre-February 24th, the pre-invasion lines, which would leave them with Crimea and part of the eastern part of Ukraine that they annexed back in 2014. He says that's not enough. He's saying that to do that to President Putin today would be akin to what happened in Munich in 1938 when Hitler wanted to was about to invade Czechoslovakia, and there was a deal made. Britain, France, Italy all signed up with Germany. Hitler promised not to annex any other parts of northern Europe, and he was given the Sudetenland, a sort of a German-speaking border area with the Czech Republic. But of course, that became seen as an appeasement. And this is what Zelensky is saying, that you make a move with somebody like Putin to give him what he wants, this territory on the ground, and he'll just come back and take more. You know, and there's evidence of what President Putin is doing now, not just taking the land, but we know just yesterday he announced it would be easier for people in the now Russian-controlled Kherson and Zaporizhia areas to get passports. That's just a step along the path to annexation. That's right out of the Russian playbook. And Zelensky is saying that too many lives have been lost, and that we shouldn't be talking in terms of appeasement. We should be thinking about all those lives lost, and that there are real people inside Ukraine that this affects. So it's a very strong and clear pushback that Zelensky and the Ukrainians are not going to let Russia take any more territory, and are going to want to take back what they got in 2014.
So, and one commentator writing in The Atlantic magazine today, quote, "Putin does not need an off-ramp. He needs to lose. Only when he is humiliated will Russia's wars of imperial conquest finally come to an end." That's Anne Applebaum writing in The Atlantic magazine. I think her words will resonate, certainly in many of the European countries that are close to Russia geographically, certainly, and feel the breath, as it were, of Moscow as a threat going forward.
Yeah, and of course, at the back of President Zelensky's mind is the fact that his military is only as strong as the weapons supplies they get. So if Kissinger's ideas take root, then there's a potential that the Ukrainians could be forced into a weaker negotiation than they wanted. And again, his reference to the 1938 in Munich, Czechoslovakia wasn't present at those talks where a deal was signed about annexing part of their territory to Germany at the time. So history there speaks very loudly to the Ukrainians. But this idea that President Putin will only stop when he meets a bigger force that's able to make him do that. At the moment, he's calculating on the fact that that's not going to happen, that he can take this territory, and who's going to push him back. And that will come down to Ukrainians, and that will come down to the resolve of the international community to take the economic pain, to take the shortage of world food supplies, and continue to supply Ukraine with the weapon systems it needs, not only to hold Russia back, but to retake territory. And of course, Putin is right now, his military is making some gains in the east of the country, which is a tough narrative for the Ukrainians. Until now, they've been able to show whatever's happening in some parts, they're making positive gains. Kharkiv being the latest major example. They obviously need, in their minds, to be able to continue to do that.
Nick Robertson is on the story for us. Nick, thank you very much indeed.